Welcome back to another W.A.F.F.L.E.S Community Robotics LEGO WeDo 2.0 tutorial. So today we're just going to kind of introduce you to the basics of the coding for the motor of the robot. If you have a robot or a WeDo kit, you're more than welcome to follow along with your robot. If you do not have a kit or a robot, you are more than welcome to use this tutorial as well to follow along, as it does introduce you to the basics of the program, which could be helpful. So you want to open up your app and it'll show you this main menu again. If you haven't, check out the how to open a project, because that'll be helpful too. You're going to go to the lower left hand corner and you're going to start a new project. And it'll load up for you here to this main page, where it will always have the play button in the middle and the red stop button in the lower right hand corner. So you can see at the bottom we have this menu that drags along the side with all these different multicolored blocks. So these are the blocks that will tell your robot what to do, or tell your computer what to do, that sort of thing. So today we're just going to be mainly focusing on the first six blocks in the green background color. These are more related to your sensor and your motors in your robot. So you can see we have this drag block down here, and to start a code, you're going to want to drag things up from the lower menu and just onto the main screen, and that will just put them there. So just go down to the menu and you drag it out. So just click and drag. It's pretty simple. So you just want to get used to basically dragging it in and out first. And if you attach the blocks to the play button, you're making a code. So once one or more blocks are attached together, you've created a code essentially. So by adding more, you're creating a longer code. So if you attach it to the play button, that is your indication of starting the code, and that's what you've chosen to do. There are other options of how to start, but we'll just start with the play button to keep it simple. So you'll just drag them all up here, and it will continue to add if you add them there. And now you've made your code here. So to get rid of it, you just drag it out and back into the menu thing, and it will disappear from your code there. So here we'll just show you the scrolling. This is all of the different blocks here, so there's different ways to start it as well, as I mentioned earlier. Next, we're going to be showing you what each of these bricks means. So we've pulled out some of the blocks here. So the one at the top that is being dragged now with the speed sign with the number 8 below it, that is going to be your speed for your robot motor and the speed that it'll move at. Then you have the time, that is going to be how long your code is running for. The X is going to tell your robot to stop or take a pause. And the turning ones with the little curved arrows, those are going to be your rotation of the motor. As well, you have the color one, that is going to change the color of your sensor. If you look below, you have these little blue squares with numbers in them. Those give you options. So we'll show you how to do that in a quick moment. Just familiarize yourself with the blocks here before we do that. And again, just a quick recap, we're going to be pulling them out and back in. That's how you delete. And again, attaching them together will create the code. You can drag them away, drag them all the way down. It's not too difficult once you get the hang of it. If you just click on these two blocks that turn, you're able to turn the rotation. As well, as I was saying, the blue drop-down menu, you just click on that and it'll give you numbers to input the speed you want, and then the time here, you can change the time. Same with this, you can click colors that are associated with certain numbers, and that will tell your robot what numbers to use. So you put it to the play button, and you're able to take that away, and then you just have that, drag that away to erase it. Again, you can drag the whole block, attach them to create the code. So just really getting used to how to use them and drag them together is really big. And you can drag them all together and get rid of it too. That is all for this video. Thank you for watching. I hope that was helpful, and stay tuned for more.